Bonjour monsieur et madame, it is me le chef Reddit, today I have a special ala Reddit for you. Bon appétit and remember to subscribe.
Andy Warhol's famously said, in the future, everyone will be world famous for 15 minutes. People of Reddit who have had their 15 minutes, what was your 15 minutes of fame? I got robbed when I worked at a servo once and beat the robber up, was in the paper and the police said they were using the footage for their Xmas party video compilation. I was left locked in a car as a baby and got a small article in the local newspaper about it. Asterisk asterisk edit, asterisk asterisk. I don't know exactly how long, probably a good few hours? I don't think I was ill as a result, but the fire brigade had to come and cut me out of the car. I have no idea why I was forgotten, I don't have the article right now, but it wasn't on purpose. My parents are very forgetful people. When I was in first grade, I got first place in a reading contest at school. The grand prize was a $100 Borders gift card, and the top 5 readers got to pie the principal in the face. The other 4 kids seemed too scared to properly pie the principal, barely touching his nose before dropping the pie. Then it was my turn. I slammed that pie into his face, and broke the principal's nose. I ended up on the front page of our small town newspaper, and the principal was in a dunk tank the next year, lol. Edit, by the way, I was panicking a bit afterwards, because this happened on stage, during a school assembly. Edit 2, to everyone asking me if I'm from their hometown, this happened about 22 years ago in Shelton, WA. A few years ago I made a website where you could mail people a bag of dicks anonymously. That seemed to get a lot of attention. When I was 5 I used to walk to my Nana's house after school which was around the corner and my mom would pick me up from there. My Nana wasn't home one day so I freaked out and I went on an hour-long walk home. Mom wasn't there so I walked back to Nana's and no one was there, so I just walked around town for a couple hours, all the while I was wondering why so many police cars were around. I eventually went to the police station where Mom was waiting for me. It turns out they got the whole police force of my town and the town over looking for me. But seriously, at least 15 cops drove right past me and I was a pretty distinct looking child. Edit, for everyone asking how I was distinct looking. I'm half Indian and lived in a mostly white area. Also I was wearing a bright red Coca-Cola backpack. So a small brown boy walking alone with a bright red backpack shouldn't have been too hard to spot for some of New Zealand's amazing police force emo. Everyone at my job was evacuated and eventually had to go home. A reporter on site asked me what the scope of the danger was and I replied, I dunno, I gotta go home and pet my cat, they used the clip. They shot a commercial for immunization at my daycare when I was about 4 yo, early 80s, I distinctly remember the day, as we all got to pick funny hats, and I was pissed BC I ended up with a giant red cowboy hat, Alberta, and everyone else had cooler hats. Commercial came out, and it's just me with my ridiculous giant hat. They would recycle the commercial every couple years, and all through junior high and high school, I'd inevitably get someone saying, I know you from somewhere, as I looked pretty much the same as my 4-year self. I'd let them sort it out on their own, and wait a couple days before they'd come running up yelling, you're that kid from the commercial. I tried desperately to get a copy of it from the Alberta government for my wedding a couple years ago, but they couldn't find it, despite some very amused and helpful staff. When I was in high school I made a playlist on YouTube of grunge music. I made it a public playlist even though it was just for my own listening. Turns out, the playlist gets millions of views and I even had bands from around the world contact me to put their music in my playlist. It fizzled out after a few years, but every now and again I remember messaging bands back and forth asking why they thought they belonged in my playlist, meanwhile my dumbass was like 16 at the time lol. I won $5,000 and a lawnmower on The Price is Right. My brother, during a high school wrestling match, taunted Ric Flair's son, after the winning move in Triple OT, with a woo and strut. Started a brawl which included Mr. Flair, wrestling MSG boards at the time hated my bro and the story made it into a Sports Illustrated. Edit, thank you for my first gold. Glad I could share my brother's story. RIP to Reed Flair. I took my kid to Europe and she slept everywhere. Asleep in every single photo, so I took her picture with strangers, police officers, soldiers, a waiter, a bride, couple of dogs. The photo series was pretty popular on a few travel pages. Misha Collins retweeted one of my tweets and followed me for like 2 weeks, then he unfollowed me. I was buying a banana in a supermarket. They were shooting a commercial there and I was there at the same time. They asked me if I would like to join. It was my lunch break and had nothing better to do. So I walked downstairs to a professional setup. Was there for 5 minutes, they took 10 pictures and gave me 100 euro. A few weeks later I saw my face all over my country and at the homepage on the website. They did not mention that the commercial would be that big. Edit, did not expect so many likes. If someone can explain how I can send a link with the photos, I would appreciate it. It wasn't a huge deal, but my rock band got to play on live radio, 94.1, a few years ago. I'm a keyboardist, so nobody cared too much. Edit, sorry for the confusion. It was 94.1 KPFA, Bay Area. I was on the top 20 bronze leaderboard on Duolingo. I was walking across Manhattan College campus. My friend needed to get his transcript and other paperwork, as he recently graduated. There was a film crew there, and they asked us if we wanted to be in a Nickelodeon commercial. My friend and I were asked to basically just walk from one side to the other in the background. We just got done smoking a big ol' joint. We thought it was a hoot. Take one. Action. We start walking. There are two girls also in this commercial, also extras, walking towards us. As we get close, one of the girls looks at me and says, "We're so high," and starts laughing. I say, "We are too." And also laugh. Hashtag CUT. Take two. Action. We start walking and the girls are already laughing before they get close to us. The laughter was infectious, and we started laughing too. Hashtag CUT. Take 3 and take 4 were uneventful, and I saw my commercial exactly once on TV. I could barely tell it was me. I was in a lawsuit with Kanye West for the cryptocurrency Coinequin that I was a developer for in 2014. I like turtles a lot. Not me, but my grandmother was briefly ranked as the 6th best player on the global leaderboards for Bejeweled Blitz. A year ago, I appeared on a news channel behind the reporter accidentally walking right into a street sign while messaging my mom. I got laughed at for at least 1 month after that. Edit, wow, thank you so much for the upvotes. I'm sorry to everyone who asked for the video, I don't have it. I searched on YT for a longo time and never found, and no familiar records it as well. I recreated What's My Age Again by Blink-182 in GTAV. It took off immediately and ended up on dozens of news sites like Entertainment Weekly, Huffington Post, and even Rolling Stone. The band also posted it on their Facebook page, which led to it trending. There is a specific popular YouTuber whose videos I watch occasionally. Every time I comment on her videos, my comment gets 13k plus likes and I have no idea why. When I was the only emo kid in the school, someone offered a penny, literally a penny, to a guy to beat me up and he took it. School staff didn't care too much, but the other students realized how fucked up the situation was and the bullying simply stopped and I could enjoy the last year in high school. Got a post to the front page and now I know Reddit has a weird fetish to fuck Danny DeVito and the Queen of England. Edit, to clarify, some people want to fuck Danny DeVito and some others the Queen of England. I had a comedy rap song chart at number 3 on SoundClick, lol. I was a baby model for those backpacks that have a baby slot. Mom and dad took me shopping for a raincoat for my dad when customer assistant just asked if they could borrow me for some modeling of their new stock due to me being so calm. I got a letter of thanks from the store manager with Polaroids and laminates for my future modeling portfolio. When my wife and I were on TLC's Strange Sex. My late dog. Son was home on break. Had been playing frisbee with the dog. Got home from work and son told me the dog was internet famous. Why? He took a pic of the dog W frisbee in mouth while pooping and titled it "Animal version of taking your cell phone to the bathroom." At that point there were over 300k views. eventually over 1.5 meters and ripped off by many. Just googled it and it's still floating around. Not me, but my mom was famous in an hospital some years ago because she was the most unluckiest person with sicknesses that are rare. When she was a kid, she always easily had allergic reactions to lots of things. Then some years before having me, she had a bloof infection. Then when I was 7, she was the 7th person in the world to have a sickness that made her spleen grow very fast and almost died because the doctors didn't realize that the reason why she was so sick was because her spleen weighed 2.5 kilograms, causing internal bleeding. So she was famous for that in the hospital because she was the first person in France to have that sickness. It was not a cancer and I don't remember the name. I accidentally helped a hoax news story blow up. It ended up becoming a global story for a whole summer. I knew from the beginning it was bullshit and was terrified someone would trace part of it back to me. Back when I was in college, doing the stanky leg dance was pretty popular. I was on Drumline and I guess ESPN was coming back from commercial break to our football game and they zoom in on the band. I'm there standing on a bench, playing cowbell and doing the stanky leg. They kept zooming in on me until the play started. Maybe just 15 seconds, but I'll take it. I had a post on this Reddit account blow up on our videos and had small newspapers report on the video giving me credit as a Reddit user. The part I'm most happy about is the video had like 10,000 views when I found it and now has about 1 million. Edit, 9 million thanks you, Professor underscore Puzzleduck. About 20 years ago, my parents' giant Norway spruce was chosen to be the Rockefeller Center Christmas tree. The tree cutting ceremony turned into a block party attended by the governor and every NYC TV news outlet. Met tons of celebrities, politicians at the lighting ceremony. Did interviews with NBC, MTV, Nat Geo, etc. My parents and I did a segment on The Daily Show. It was a whirlwind couple of weeks, but NBC really hooked us up.
Thank you for watching. What was your favorite answer? Do you have a better one? Comment it down below. Au revoir.